goes come. There goes my mind racing, and you are the reason that I'm still breathing. I'm hopeless now.
I climb every mountain, swim every ocean,
just to be with you. And fix what I've broken.
Oh, 'cause I need you to see you are the reason.
There goes my head shaking, and you are the reason. My heart keeps bleeding, I need you now.
If I could turn back the clock, I'd make sure the light defeated the dark. I'd spend every hour of every day keeping you safe. And I'd climb every
God and the hill you can understand.
Thank you. Who gives his bride in marriage?
That mother.
Dearly beloved, we are gathered together here in the sight of God and in the face of this company to join together this man and this woman in holy matrimony, which is commended of God to be honorable among all men and therefore not to be entered into unadvisedly or lightly, but reverently, discreetly, advisedly, and in the fear of God. And to this holy estate, these two persons come now to be joined. You would bow your heads for a moment of prayer. Lord, we thank you and give you all the praise, for this is the day that you have made, and we rejoice and are glad in it. We ask that your presence would saturate this moment of worship and commitment, as these two promise their undying love to one another. Seal this ceremony with the Holy Spirit, and we know that what you have joined together, no man can put asunder. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. You may be seated. This is a beautiful and exciting day. Great weather. Amen. The Lord worked it out for us, didn't he? Amen. After all the careful planning, the money set aside, the personal growth and honesty achieved, you are here in the sight of God, your loved ones, and friends, to commit your lives to one another. You have been blessed to find the one in whom your soul loves, to share your Christian journey together, to live out your lives and dreams with one another. So smile. Smiling exercise. Everybody. Amen. This is a beautiful and exciting day. I want to ask you a question that will set the tone for our ceremony today. Maurice, have you accepted Jesus Christ as your Lord and personal Savior? Sierra, have you accepted Jesus Christ as your Lord and personal Savior? Yeah. Now, upon public profession of your faith, you have made known to all men that Jesus Christ of Nazareth is the Lord and Savior of your lives. Let's give God praise for that. As Christians, we know that God has given us a blueprint for success called the Bible. It has the words of truth and faith and guides us. So I'm going to read to you from the scriptures about marriage in the book of Ephesians. And it goes like this. You wives, will submit to your husbands as you do to the Lord. For a husband is the head of his wife as Christ is the head of his body, the church. He gave his life to be her Savior. As the church submits to Christ, so you wives must submit to your husbands in everything. And you husbands must love your wives with the same love Christ showed the church. He gave up his life for her to make her holy and clean, washed by baptism and God's word. He did this to present her to himself as a glorious church without a spot or wrinkle or any other blemish. Instead, she will be holy and without fault. In the same way, husbands ought to love their wives as they love their own bodies. For a man is actually loving himself when he loves his wife. No one hates his body, but lovingly cares for it, just as Christ cares for his body, which is the church. And we are his body, as the scripture says. A man leaves his father and mother and is joined to his wife, and the two are united into one. This is a great mystery, but it is an illustration of the way Christ and the church are one. Now at Church KCC, we know that marriage is a decision to live with another imperfect person for the rest of your lives in a way that brings glory to God and fulfillment to your lives. And the world has an idea that marriage is simply a legal contract, a set of papers that you fill out. We know that's not the case. Though it is legally binding, if it was just that, there are loopholes that give you the option to make a casual commitment. And I know that's not your desire. The God we serve loves us. He loves us unconditionally. Bishop O'Neill says it like this: he knows us completely, but loves us anyway. You can depend on his love because it's deep and everlasting. His love is without condition, meaning that in good times and bad times, up or down times, whether happy or not so much, even when we disappoint him, he loves us. And oh, how he loves us. God didn't make marriage to be simply a legal contract. He called for it to be a spiritual covenant, such that the same kind of unconditional love he offers to us, we offer to one another. That's what you step into today. So Maurice and Sierra, you are about to cut covenant with one another. As you pledge your vows to each other and as you commit your lives to each other, I charge you to do so in all seriousness and yet with a deep sense of joy. This is a joyous day. With the deep conviction that you are committing yourselves to love each other with the love of the Lord, full of compassion, gracious, long-suffering, and filled with mercy and honesty. To the witnesses, Jesus said in the 18th chapter of Matthew, "Again I say unto you, that if two of you shall agree on earth as touching anything, they shall ask, and it shall be done for them of my Father which is in heaven." You are here for a serious purpose, to bear witness to this union and to stand in agreement with them for good success. So this is what I'm going to ask you to do. Offer to them your acceptance. Make friends with them. You may be on one side or the other, but there are no more sides anymore. Amen? So make friends with the other side. Offer to them your prayers. Talk to God on their behalf. They're going to need your prayers. Offer to them your protection. Stand up for them. In other words, don't let nobody put their mouth on them. Amen? Amen? And then offer to them your goodwill. Always speak good of their will. Speak good of them. Because he who created them from the beginning made them male and female and said, "Therefore a man shall leave his father and mother and hold fast to his wife, and the two shall become one flesh." So they are no longer two, but one flesh. What therefore God has joined together, let no man put asunder. Let's get to the news. Maurice Gerald, do you take Seattle to be your wedded wife, to live together after God's ordinance in the holiest state of matrimony? Will you love her, honor and keep her in sickness and in health, for richer or for poorer, and forsaking all those, keep thee only unto her so long as you both shall live? I do. So say aye and state your name.
Aye. Gerald.
According to the word of God.
According to the word of God.
Leave my father and my mother.
Leave my father and my mother.
And I join myself to you. Look at her.
And I join myself to you.
To be a husband to you.
To be a husband to you.
From this moment forward.
From this moment forward.
We shall be one.
We shall be one.
Sierra. Do you take Maurice to be your wedded husband? To live together after God's ordinance in the holiest state of matrimony. Will you obey and serve him?
Sorry.
Got nothing more to do. Love, honor, and keep. In sickness and in health. For richer or for poorer. And forsaking all others, keep thee only unto him so long as you both shall live. There you go. So turn to him. State your name. According to the word of God. Submit myself to you. To be a wife to you. From this moment forward. We shall be. They have the bride's ring. A ring is a very precious thing, made of precious metal to represent the precious nature of your union, made of strong metal to represent the strength and resilience of your union. It's the never-ending circle that declares an eternal bond that it represents. As he gives you this ring, it is a sign to you that you are his choice. Scripture in Ephesians says that the wife is to submit to her own husbands, and this in this modern day seems like a place where it puts you in an inferior position, but that is not God's plan. To submit in that context is to be placed under the protection. He promises to watch over you, to protect you, and to keep you. Open your heart to him and commit to him and love him. Lord, we pray that he who gives this ring and she who wears it does so in love and in faith for the rest of their lives. In Jesus' name, amen. Take this ring. Place it on her finger. And say,
with this ring,
I do wear. It is a token of my love for you. And my faith that I release now. In Jesus' name. May I have the groom's ring? Same precious metal, same strong metal, same never-ending circle. It's bigger because it represents the strength of the responsibility that you have. You stand as her protector. So as she gives this ring to you, it represents her trust in you. As you take it, you should be reminded constantly that when a man finds a wife, he finds a good thing and attains favor. So let us pray, Lord. We pray that she who gives this ring and he who wears it does so in love and in faith for the rest of their lives. In Jesus' name, amen. You take this ring. Place it on his finger. And as you do, say, with this ring, I be wed. I give it as a token of my faith. I believe with all my heart that this is forever. It's my love and my faith. In Jesus' name, amen. Give the Lord a praise for that. Now, as a token of your union, you have chosen to perform the sand ceremony. You can step forward. Maybe take a moment to symbolize the union through the pouring of these two individual containers of sand. One representing you, Maurice, and the other representing you, Sierra, and all that you were, and all that you are, and all that you will be. And these two containers of sand are poured into the third container, the individual containers of sand will no longer exist. They'll be joined together as one. Just as these grains of sand flow seamlessly and can never be separated, I pray for you today that you will live together and be blended like the sand. and no other love will do. Every moment that you smile chases all the pain away. Forever and a while, and my heart is where you'll stay. This is why I love you. Ooh, this is why I love you. Because you love me. You love me. This is why I love you. Oh, this is why I love you. Because you love me. You love me. The stars have all aligned, and right now is the perfect time to say, I love you, I love you, I love you, I love you, I love you. As a representative of Jesus Christ, before Almighty God and in the name of the Father, His Son, and by the power of the Holy Spirit, I now pronounce you one together. You are now husband and wife. Now, ladies and gentlemen, I present to you for the first time Mr. and Mrs. Maurice Gerald II.